there's no comparison to watch comedy. There's just absolutely no, it's impossible to mimic or copy the experience of a stand-up club. There's just no theatre can do that. The reason why arenas and theatres and bloody stadiums for people like Seinfeld to perform at, the reason why they're doing that is 100%, of course it is money. That guy makes millions of dollars to get up on stage. You know, how's anyone ever going to pay him to come perform at a little club? You know, and not only his millions of dollars, but the infrastructure surrounding, like a touring band. You know, that's what they have to do. I do get it, but it's the management and the solicitors and all that. That's it. But deep down, I think that the integrity of a comedian, while you get into this, is to get into a little space and pick a microphone up and have a go, be funny. That's what I think.
Oh, they're on. That's okay. I must have left them on. I'll just put these ones on. Rightio. So, it just started one day when we had a really huge lot of stars turn up one night. So we took photos of them and stuck them on the wall. And then people started saying, oh, well, can you put my photo on the wall? It sort of become a thing. Doesn't necessarily mean these are the biggest stars or the best acts or something, but they're just all good acts that have been here and played the venue one or two times or many times.
You know, I don't think it's missing. I think it's out there still, so much of it. I was just talking about the few people that I've come across, very few, a lot are great, small minority of people that are just made some success and just pulled up the drawbridge, forgetting about any assistance that they may have had on the way. So, well, that's it. As far as I'm concerned, that sort of summarizes their character for those very few people.
A lot of these people I've known for a long time. Joel Creasy, he started his comedy career with us. He's doing pretty well now. Dave Callan, Chris Franklin, you know, the bloke, I'm a yobbo, my best friend is a yobbo, that bloke song. Peter Rowsthorn, you know, from Kath and Kim, he's a really good stand-up. There's Dilruk Jayasinghe, Greg Fleet, and Iman Hadichi, who's the smallest comedian in the world, I think. Rove, he comes fairly regularly to the venue. Brendan Burns, he's just actually coming out of rehab, so it's... See how he goes, he's back in town. Steve Hughes, he's pretty, they're all good acts. Fiona O'Loughlin, Craig Quartermain, he's doing all right for himself. He started his comedy career with us. He's doing a bit of work on the ABC. Janelle Kearney, great regular with us. Ivan Aristigueta, Corey White, very controversial. No, some good stars we've had over the years.
If I had to say about the importance of a good club as opposed to a great comedian in a crap club with, you know, too much glass around and no backdrop and a bad sound system and all the things that can spoil the experience, it reminds me of a bit like wine. If you really enjoy a glass of red, you pay $100 a bottle for this red, you pour it into a thick jam jar type cheap glass and you drink that red, it's okay, but it's the experience isn't there, right? You just not, it just you can't enjoy it because of that, because the glass is ruining the experience. That's a comedian in a bad environment. But if you get a really good club like this one, when you get an act that's okay, you know, because they are, some acts just aren't quite there yet, bring out the best in them, shall we say. But a bit like that wine analogy is that if you get an okay wine at 35 a bottle, but put it in a beautiful hand-blown Villeroy and Bosch glass with plenty of swirl room, and you know, that becomes bloody fantastic. And that's what I think happens with comedians. If they're in an environment where they're really available to sort of flourish, then that good venue will bring out an even better performance.
Quite a few of them have pretty much started their careers with Raw or just coming in to do open mic with us. And others, you know, have just happened to already made it on the East Coast and just come over and play the venue. But yeah, there's a big mix of people. Jim Jefferies has been in. Sacha Baron Cohen even turned up once. Well, three times. Yeah, every single act here that you see on the wall has played at the venue. One exception is this one, Jim Owen. He hasn't played, he just came in for a few drinks, but I like Jim Owen, he's a good act, so I just thought we'd put him on there in lieu of him performing. That's my philosophy. He might feel obliged to perform now. No, one night it was just crazy. We had Tom Gleason, Peter Hellier, Russell Peters, Arj Barker, Dave Hughes, all those, one, two, three, four, five. That was such a big lineup that you just, honestly, it was crazy.
And we often will get, comedians will say that's the best. I mean, they probably say it to every club, but don't get me wrong, I'm not stupid. But often we do get someone that's taken a roof off and you go, wow, that was next level. And they come off stage and they say, yeah, that was wonderful. That was the best time I've ever had on a stage. And I believe them, even though it may be what they say to everyone. I feel my ego allows me to believe that that's probably true because I've built a really, really good club.
You know, when you sort of, you like to sort of remember those stars that turned up. I don't know if that man was on that night or not, it might have been six. But yeah, really good lineup. And there was a couple more, they were big names, it wasn't. There's so many, anyway. He's been once or twice. We got, yeah, so many of them. There's this, where is he now? Ron. Oh God! No, this guy. Forget you. I just can't think of his name. Anyway, he's a big star in the UK. Jim Jefferies, Matt. Well, there's so many I could go through. It'd be boring, you know, for everyone. No one, I don't care.